Afraid to find some. reaching for his keys. And every time that Greenland falls in the fucking sea, it's because all of us, the brightest ones, should call her versions every time of ethnic group, even folks from Guadeloupe, the old, the young, toothless hands, supermodels, actors, fans, bleeding hearts, football stars, men in bars, washerwomen, tailors, tarts, grannies, grandmothers, uncles, aunts, friends, relations, hopeless tramps, clerics, truckers, cleaning ladies, ants, well, maybe not ants. Well, because it's true that ants don't have enough IQ to differentiate between the pain that other people feel. And well, for instance, cutting leaves or crawling across windowsills in search of open treacle tins. So like the ants, are we just dumb? Is that why we don't feel or see? Or are we all just numbed out on reality TV? So every time the curtain falls, every time the curtain falls on some forgotten life, it is because we all stood by silent and indifferent. It's normal.
Thank you. on it in English. Short, sharp, shock. They don't do it again. You get, I mean, he got a mic. I could give him a flash of light. I think it's a mic.
Thank you. Starts playing the tune. Gracias. Muchas gracias. Wow. It has been a great privilege and a great, great pleasure to play for you tonight. And I speak for my band, I know. So thank you. I need to change the tone. We're going to do two more songs. I just want to sort of bask in your love for a minute, if I may. From the very last record that I made with Pink Floyd, and the record was called The Final Cut, in that year. And we made it in 1982, and the song is the last song on the record, and it's called Two Suns in the Sunset. And thank you. Yeah, somebody knows it. And it's important now because it's a song about a bloke who was driving home one night to see his family, and the Third World War starts, and so of course he does. And the problem is that it's very, very likely to happen very, very soon, because our leaders are insane. So if you run into one of our leaders at some point, suggest to them that they should go down to the bar and have a chat with the other leaders and say, should we just get rid of all these nuclear weapons and start building schools and hospitals and things that people actually need, please? Because that's what the heck they want, all right? I'm going to need more water because I have to keep bending down. I've got a bad leg. I mean, I told the audience this yesterday. I've strained an Achilles tendon, which is why I'm hobbling around a bit. So I'm just going to take a sip of this and then hang on. So there we are. So it's about that. In 1947, they formed a committee of eminent atomic scientists, and they came up with the idea of the doomsday clock. And it's an imaginary clock, but it's ticking and it's getting ever nearer to midnight. And if that second hand ever reaches midnight, that is the nuclear holocaust. And then we're all dead. Not just us and our children and grandchildren, but all the grasshoppers, everything. Gone. End of planet Earth. End of the whole history of the whole thing. So it's very important that we try and do everything we can to not let that happen. In 1947, I've no idea where they set it, but it was probably about 10 to midnight. Last year, it was 100 seconds to midnight. This year, they reset it recently, it's 90 seconds to midnight. So, prenez garde, I would say. I think I can hear it ticking behind me now.
Thank you.
the windshield melts and your tears evaporate. Leaving all charcoal to the deep end. Finally, you'll understand the feelings I feel. Ashes and diamonds. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Back to the bar. I wish you could all join us around this piano, but there's too many of you, okay? But as far as we are concerned, in our hearts, you're all with us here on the stage, and I'm gonna, along with Amanda and Sinead and Robert and John and Dave and Joey and Seamus and Jonathan, who's pouring, and Gus, who's waiting. Guys, that's to us. And this is to you lot. Cheers! Okay, so to conclude this evening's show, I don't know why I'm laughing. I tell you why I'm laughing, because I'm happy. I am happy to be, that is why I'm laughing. It's taken me 60 years of hard work to get here, and I'm so happy I got here, and I'm here with you tonight. Alright. So, we're gonna do one more verse of the bar. I stole some of the lyrics from Bob Dylan, so don't tell him. Well, no, if you tell him, who cares? Bob, in 1966, he made a great record called Blonde on Blonde. It was a double vinyl album. And the fourth side is a very long song called Sad Eyed Lady of the Lowlands. And when I was writing the bar during COVID, it came to me and I just used it. So I'd used the word sad eyed lady and also the words big brass bed, which any of those of you who know the song will know. So thank you, Bob. That's one thing. And then the sad eyed lady who I mentioned in the first line of this song, I know well. She's my wife, Camila. She's at home in bed right now. So I shall see her later. But she is my rock, so I thank her. And also, sadly, I had a big brother, my brother John, who's a little bit older than me, and he died suddenly last year. So I want to dedicate this performance as well to my big brother John. slaughtering some bush jumping snakes and dance here with you to the didgeridoo and listen while you sing all the maps. Is that a foghorn in the distance? Heading for the rocks. Come sit here by the fireside and hold me in your arms. And tell me, how was life before the cops? Thank you.